Students, we have completed with the first chapter, Hello Alkenes and Hello Arenes. Hope so. You have taken down the assignment questions and trying to write the answers for them. Now, the next chapter includes three classes of organic compounds containing oxygen. So, organic compounds containing oxygen, the three classes of organic compounds are alcohols, phenols and ethers. We shall study each of them in detail. The first class in this is alcohols. Now let us look to the definition of alcohols. Alcohols are hydroxy derivatives of hydrocarbons. OH group is called as the hydroxy group. So alcohols are hydroxy derivatives of hydrocarbons in which the hydroxy group is attached to a saturated carbon atom. What do you mean by a saturated carbon atom? A carbon atom bonded by single bonds. So OH group here will be the functional group of alcohols. I hope you all remember the definition of functional group. An atom or group of atoms which determines the characteristics of an organic compound is called as a functional group. Now, after looking to the definition of alcohols, you need to know the general formula of these alcohols. The general formula of alcohols is given by ROH, where R is an alkyl group essentially, or substituted alkyl group, because the hydroxy group is to be bonded to a saturated carbon atom. You can also represent the general formula as CnH2n plus 1 OH. If you look to this general formula, compare it with alkanes. CnH2n plus 2 is the general formula of alkanes. So one of the hydrogen is replaced by the functional group OH. So here it becomes CnH2n plus 1 OH. Both are correct for alcohols. Now coming to the classification of alcohols. Alcohols are classified according to the number of hydroxy groups present in the molecule. The alcohols containing one OH group are called as monohydric alcohols. Examples are ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH, benzyl alcohol, C6H5CH2OH. Now, those alcohols containing two hydroxy groups are called as dihydric alcohols. If you look there, CH2 double bond, CH2 is ethene or ethylene. Now the double bond is replaced by two hydroxy groups. The name of this compound will be ethylene glycol, an example for a dihydric alcohol. Now alcohols containing three hydroxy groups in a molecule are called as trihydric alcohols. If you look there, CH2OH, single bond CHOH, single bond CH2OH is an example for trihydric alcohol called as glycerol. Now, moving further, these monohydric alcohols containing one OH group in a molecule are further classified based on the hybridization of the carbon atom to which the OH group is attached. Now, further classification of monohydric alcohols. The compounds containing sp3oh bond, that is the hydroxy group bonded to sp3 hybridized carbon atom. The hydroxy group is attached to an sp3 hybridized carbon atom, once again of an alkyl group. They are of the following types. The first set is primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols. I hope you remember what do you mean by a primary, secondary and a tertiary carbon atom, which I have told in the chapter Halo Alkenes and Halo Arenes. Now coming to primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols, this classification is done depending on whether the hydroxy group is attached to a primary carbon atom or a secondary carbon atom or a tertiary carbon atom. Now, this is one classification. To give an example for a primary alcohol, ethyl alcohol, CH3CH2OH. To give an example for a secondary alcohol, it is isopropyl alcohol, CH3CHOHCH3. To give an example of a tertiary alcohol, it is CH3 thrice COH, an example for tertiary alcohol. So this is one class. Now moving to the second type, they are called as allylic alcohols. I have told you what is an allyl group. CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH2 is called as allyl group. Here OH group is bonded to the allylic group, CH2 double bond, CH2OH. It is in particular a primary allylic alcohol. So primary allylic alcohol, example is prop2-ene-1-ol. IUPAC name, this is out of interest I have given. You all should know how to write the IUPAC name when the structure is given. Now coming to the secondary allylic alcohol. Here the hydroxy group is bonded to the secondary carbon of allylic group. CH2 double bond CH single bond CHOH CH3 is a secondary allylic alcohol. Now coming to Bute 2, so the IUPAC name of this compound is Bute 3-ene-2-ol. Yes, next coming to tertiary allylic alcohol, CH2 double bond CHC CH3CH3OH. Here the hydroxy group is bonded to tertiary carbon of allylic group. The IUPAC name of this compound is 2-methyl-bute-3-ene-2-ol. Yes. Now coming to the next class, that is benzylic alcohols. C6H5CH3 is called as toluene. As you all know, if you remove one hydrogen from toluene, you will get C6H5CH2, which is called as benzyl group. Now here C6H5CH2OH is a primary benzylic alcohol, which is also called as phenyl methanol, benzyl alcohol or phenyl methanol. Now secondary benzylic alcohol, OH is bonded to a secondary carbon of benzyl group. Its IUPAC name is 2-phenylethanol. Yes. Now coming to tertiary benzylic alcohol, hydroxy group is bonded to a tertiary carbon of benzylic group. It is 2-phenylpropane-2-ol. So this is first class. The second class of compounds are the compounds containing OH group bonded to sp2 hybridized carbon atom. Only one class of compounds are there. They are called as vinylic alcohols. CH2 double bond CH is called as a vinyl group. So vinylic alcohol will be CH2 double bond CH single bond OH. Now the IUPAC name will be ethanol, because there is a double bond in this. So this is in detail regarding the classification of alcohols. Once you know the definition and classification, the next very important part to be discussed is nomenclature of alcohols. Now coming to the nomenclature of alcohols, two systems of naming are there, as you all know. One is the common system, the other is the IUPAC system. Now in the common system, the name given is alkyl alcohol. The alkyl group attached to the hydroxy group is named first and alcohol is added as a separate word. Whereas coming to the IUPAC system, in particular monohydric alcohols containing one OH group, the general IUPAC name given is alkanol. Now this name alkanol is obtained by replacing E of corresponding alkane by OL. So it is alkanol. Now you should remember that after selecting the longest possible chain of carbon atoms with the hydroxy group, you should number it in such a way that the carbon to which hydroxy group is bonded gets the minimum number and then give the IUPAC name of that particular alcohol. A few examples are given there. The first structure, CH3OH, its common name is methyl alcohol. IUPAC name will be methanol. And next, increase a methylene group, you will get CH3CH2OH, which is the alkyl group, ethyl group. So it is ethyl alcohol. Coming to the IUPAC name, ethane, E is replaced by OL, so ethanol. The next example is that of CH3CH2CH2OH, N-propyl alcohol, which is also called as propane-1-ol. Yes, next is CH3CH-CH3OH. Here isopropyl group is there, CH3 twice CH. Hence the common name will be isopropyl alcohol. I have told about this in the previous chapter, N-isoneo, when they are to be used. Coming to the IUPAC name, it will be propane-2-ol. Yes, the next structure, CH3CH2CH2CH2OH, straight chain compound with 4 carbon atoms. The common name will be N-butyl alcohol. The IUPAC name will be butane-1-ol. The next structure, when hydroxy group is bonded to a secondary carbon with 4 carbon atoms in the chain, the common name will be secondary butyl alcohol. Whereas coming to its IUPAC name, it will be butane-2-ol. Where you replace E by OL, there you should indicate the locant or number. Please remember, students. Next structure, it is CH3 thrice COH, which is nothing but quaternary carbon atom is present. Hence, CH3 thrice C group is there. Common name we use tertiary butyl alcohol. IUPAC name will be 2-methylpropane-2-ol. To the second carbon atom, there is a methyl group and OH group is bonded to the second carbon atom. So, therefore, it is 2-methylpropane-2-ol. So, these are a few examples of monohydric alcohols, their common names as well as the IUPAC names. Now, coming to the dihydric and trihydric alcohols. Dihydric alcohols in the IUPAC system are called as alkane diols. If you take the same example of ethylene glycol, which I had written in the classification, 2 carbon atoms are there. The alkane having 2 carbon atoms is ethane. So, its IUPAC name will be ethane-1,2-diol. Coming to trihydric alcohols. In case of trihydric alcohols, there will be 3 hydroxy groups, and in the IUPAC system, they are called as alkane triols. And the example taken is that of, yes, glycerol. Glycerol in the IUPAC system is called as propane-1,2,3-triol. 3 hydroxy group are there, so you should indicate the number to which the hydroxy groups are bonded. So this is in detail regarding the definition, classification and nomenclature of alcohols. The next part is to know about the methods of preparation.